We exited Black Friday and Thanksgiving weekend observing two key trends for retail sales. First is abating pain in brick and mortar, some signs of stabilization. Secondly is the ongoing big picture trend of market share migrating online. Now, why would brick and mortar stabilize? First of all, the role of Black Friday in retailers' marketing plans and in the consumer psyche seems to have stabilized. There were years of a building arms race, companies adding more hours, more people, more marketing, more focus on Black Friday. Last year, there was a bit of a revolt against that, with companies pulling back. But the role of Black Friday in their marketing plans seems to have stabilized at a comfortable level for retailers and consumers. Another point I'd make is that business has been good and improving for retailers through the year. The third quarter saw the best same-store sales growth for U.S. retail since the end of 2014. This, we think, reflects a solid economy, good income growth, good wage growth, building consumer net worth. And also, keep in mind, we're cycling the period last year surrounding the presidential election, which was clearly distracting for consumers. And finally, the weather was cooperative. Wherever you live, it was likely dry, no rain, no snow. It might have been chilly in New York, and warm on the West Coast, but there is no precipitation to keep you indoors. As we look out to the rest of the holiday season, our expectation is a bit of moderation in the rate of same-store sales growth for U.S. retailers, in part because we think that this will be a season when online continues to take share at an accelerated rate. The other point we make is that we're likely to see some suspense. Consumers tend to look forward to Black Friday and Thanksgiving weekend, really focus on this, the media focuses on it, but then business tends to pause. Traffic tends to fade, and consumers are waiting typically later and later each year till the last minute build up to Christmas.